Good morning. Wish you a very, very happy Ramadan. BDTX team, welcome all of the participants of this webinar. My name is Pankaj. I am the host of today's webinar. During this lockdown period, we are conducting a series of webinars. In today's session, I am going to show you how to do more effective research by using Manupatra. Before starting presentation, I would like to brief about Manupatra. As you know, Manupatra pioneered in online legal research in India since 2001, is India's premier legal information resource. Manupatra is driven by natural language processing, analytics, artificial intelligence, visualization tools, extensive hyperlinking to the judgment, act, rule, notification, circular. We are a hardcore technology company. We are the largest content aggregator. I'll explain you the detail about the database coverage. I'll explain you how to make your legal research simple, relevant, fast with Manupatra's AI-enabled platform. So I'm directly showing you the product. So first of all, I would like to explain how to start your research work. So we have given a two type of access. One is the sign-in ID password-based access. And in the colleges, universities, we have given the IP-based access. For the sign-in ID password-based access, simply we have to type that sign-in and ID, sign-in and password. Like whatever the things I have, the sign-in and password, I'm typing here. For the IP-based access, you will get the link here, IP user, click here. So in this place, you have to click and then you will get the database access. So you have to simple in the, you have to just type the www.manupatra.com. Either that site will come on that place or the manupatrafast.com, that the both the things are the same. So, and then you can start that researching the on the databases. So I'm just signing here. So this is the home page. On this home page, the right hand side, the top, you're getting the search parameters, Manu search, legal search, citation search, assisted search. I'll explain these things one by one, how you take the advantage of these parameters. Some of the icons and features are available in the this middle box. So I'll explain these features as well. Left hand side, you are getting the table of content. I'm explaining you what we provide in the Manupatra. So you can see here. So here you will get the Supreme Court. This is the Supreme Court of India's decision from the inception. We have given the Supreme Court judgment as well as the order of Supreme Court. You will get there. Then the extensive coverage of all High Court decisions from the inception. You will get the judgment of all the Indian High Court decisions. You will get there. In this place, you will get the other courts. Whatever the court were there pre-50, pre-independence. So these court decisions you will get there. Like suppose that sometimes you search in the Privy Council decision or Lahore decisions. So you will get that these decisions as well. Like the Privy Council, you will get the 1820 onwards. Coverage of the databases is 1820 onwards. So this is the Supreme Court and all High Court decisions of India. Then the Indian Tribunals and Commissions orders you will get here. So whatever the tribunals and commissions are in India, you will get the orders of these tribunals and commissions, like National Green Tribunal, Income Tax Appellate Tribunal, and various tribunals, more than 38 tribunals and commissions we have covered there. You will get the orders on of these tribunals and commissions. This international database part, first of all, I'd like to show you the coverage of Bangladesh. So in this place, you will get the our country's decision of the case laws, statutes, and ordinance. So in the case law, you will get the pre-70 cases as well. So whatever the decisions of earlier Dhaka court or the pre-70 courts of the things you will get there. With the coverage of our Supreme Court of Appellate Division and High Court Division. So from the very inception, you will get the decisions of these Supreme Court and High Court decisions. Apart from these Bangladesh decisions, in the international databases, you will get the so many other countries' judgment as well. Like you are seeing the Australia, Canada, Hong Kong, New Zealand, Pakistan, Singapore, South Africa, Sri Lanka, UK, United States. So these countries, this more apart from the US, all of these countries are the Commonwealth English-speaking countries. Like in the UK, you can see here the decisions of Supreme Court, House of Lords, England and Wales Court of Appeal, England and Wales High Court, Tribunals and Privy Council, High Court of Justice of Northern Ireland, Queensland. So this is the UK coverage you will get there. Similarly, you will get the Supreme Court of US decisions from the very beginning. And then the federal court decisions you will get there with the statutes of this US. And similarly, you can browse these countries' decisions as well. Apart from these countries' decisions, you will get the decisions of the International Court of Justice, English report, the maritime cases, Court of Justice of European Community. So these decisions you will get as well in the databases of coverage of in your Manupatra. So it's a very extensive coverage of case laws. In the Dhaka, Bangladesh, I have explained you about the case laws. Similarly, you will get the statutes. So whatever the Bayer Act you want to see, you can browse that Bayer Act. You can see that full text of the Bayer Act. Simply, you have to click here, and you can by click first alphabet of the Bayer Act. Like suppose that I have clicked here the C, so it will start from that C alphabet, and you can browse that Bayer Act from this place. So these list you will get there, and whatever the Bayer Act you want to see here, so simply you have to click here. So it will open that Bayer Act section wise. You can read that particular section one by one section you can read. Or if you want to see these Bayer Act in single doc, so simply you have to click here, and the single doc option is there. By clicking as a single doc, you can read that one, or you can save that things. So the entire Bayer Act with amendment history you will get there. So these Bayer Act you will get there. So in this place, you will get that case law as well as the Bayer Act. For browsing the Indian Bayer Acts, we have given the separate this link here. So you have to click here the plus mark, then you can open the Central Bayer Act of India and State Bayer Act of India. So in the Central Bayer Act, you will get all the Bayer Acts of the Central Bayer Act of India. And the similar fashion you can see here in the alphabetical order wise or chronological order wise. You can, like suppose that I have to write the Code of Civil Procedure, so simply I have to click here. So when I click C, so it will appear, it will show you that table here. So simply I have to scroll down, and then I'll get the Civil Procedure Code. So I can, when I click here, I'll get that list of the section. Some of the Bayer Act we have given the commentaries as well. On the 21 Bayer Act of Indian Bayer Act, you will get the commentaries. For whatever the Bayer Act, we have given the commentaries. In front of the section, you will get that commentary link. So you can see the commentary of that particular section. So this is the way to browse the Bayer Act. Simply, you have to click on that thing, central state, and then you can develop. Similarly, you will get all the rules of that particular Bayer Act, rules, regulation of Indian content, you will get there. So then apart from that, The coverage detail, you will get that all the bills, committee reports, all the committee reports of the, like, suppose that Indian law commission reports, you want to study the various law commission report of India. So you can open that law commission report, then the constituent assembly debates, then the various draft date agreements format of various laws. So you can browse that thing. Whatever the bill which is pending in parliament, you will get the status of that particular bill. So simply you have to click here and you can see whatever the bill which is pending in the Indian parliament. You can browse that thing by clicking here wise. So it will show you the status of that particular bill. So the entire detail you will get that. So in this way, you can browse that where bills. Then you will get that some of the ebooks. These ebooks, you will get here the list of the ebooks. So you can browse the ebooks. Some of the academic ebooks as well, you will get here. So you can browse these academic ebooks as well. So these ebooks are also available in the site. Then we have given the articles. This is again the very important part for you. So you can browse the article, whatever the article written by the student, we have segregated the list, article by professionals, article journals, newsletter by law firms, case studies, brief, moot, memorials. Sometimes if you are appearing in the moot court, so you can see the various moot memorials here. So you can browse these moot memorials. Like suppose that I have to see this moot memorials of environmental moot court competition. So these moot memorials are there. So you can browse that one. You can see that things. So it will help you to get these content. And you can search as well in these articles. Legal taxonomy, I will explain these things. So this is the table of content part. Before moving the search part, how to refine the search, how to do a research work. Some of the features on this page, important features I'll show you. Like here you will get the compare provision. Now in this compare provision, you are getting here the constitution of different countries. So whatever the country's constitution, if you want to read, so that is very simple. There is no need to search anywhere. Simply you have to download in the PDF or view in the HTML. So you can download these 192 countries' constitution. And you can compare these constitution on these parameters as well. Like suppose that I have to compare the constitution of India and Afghanistan. So first of all, I have to select that things. So like suppose that I have selected this people and I have to select the see the compare provision of people in India and Pakistan, Afghanistan. So I have to select here and say compare. So in the comparative mode, you will get the two countries, like the Afghanistan is coming there and India's constitution you are seeing here. And just you can scroll, click here the drop down things and you will get the where the these topic related things. So it will highlight that portion and easily you can compare these part. So even you can compare the Indians to Central Act as well. Now the most important part, what you are doing on a day-to-day basis, that is the search part. For the researching, it's very important. Like we have an extensive coverage, very large databases we have covered there, either the our country's Bangladesh or the Indian databases or the other international countries' databases, whatever you are getting there. So for the search part, we have given the search parameter Manu search, legal search, citation search, assisted search. One by one, I'll take one some examples and I'll explain you these features, how to search. As I explain you, Manupatra is driven by like these natural language processing and artificial intelligence. These things are incorporated when you search, these tools are there. So simply you have to type your query, simply you have to type your word, it will give the most real result first of all. Like suppose that if you are searching on any of the matter related to service law and the topic is just seniority, and that you are searching case law as well as the promotion as well. So if anybody is litigation related to seniority and promotion, so simply I have to type these two words, whatever the things there. When you search, it will search the entire databases. I can see here. So I have searched, I have not selected any databases. I got this read. So it will give you the first of all, whatever the important decisions you will get in the first page. So in this page, you will get this number of decision. Then further you will get the filter result. These party name are appearing here, the case law related to that particular topic. And the further filter option you will get there. If you want to see the any of the court like the Bangladesh Supreme Court Appellate Division, so simply you have to scroll here. Then you in the list, you will get that the Bangladesh Appellate Division 139 case, Bangladesh High Court Division 118 cases. So this filter option is there. Further, you can filter any keywords wise. So sometimes some of the words which is already in your mind, you want to find out that search on that one, but couldn't able to recall that word. So these keyword will help you, like ad hoc appointment. So I have to further narrow down ad hoc appointment. Either I can click here or I can search in the menu, sir. So these things you will get there. Then the honorable judges name wise, then the year wise you can filter. Then most important, you are getting the bits wise, and you are getting searched here the articles as well on that seniority and promotions. So on a single search, you are getting all these parameters. So you can read the judgment of larger bench as well. So first of all, I am just showing the one judgment. How can you utilize the various feature which is available inside the judgment? Now you can see here, I opened the one judgment of Supreme Court of India. You are getting the Manu citation. And whatever the equivalent citation, like the our coverage of in India, we have covered more than 300 equivalent citations. Similarly, in the Bangladesh, you will get the various other equivalent citations like the BLD, BLT, ADC. So these coverage you will get there. So I opened the Supreme Court of India. So when I click here, it will give you the equivalent citation like the AIR, SCR. So these equivalent citations you will get there in the top. The full text of judgment you are getting there. This is on the basis of service matter, subject is that, whatever the act rule which is mentioned here, which case which is referred in case this judgment, you will get the list of that judgment, prior history of that judgment, and this is the facts, case note of that particular case, is the part, and then this is the full text of judgment. So at the time of reading the judgment, sometimes you want to know the meaning of any word, legal interpretation of that word. So like suppose that this word, common name, so you will get the legal interpretation of that word. So instantly you will get that meaning of that thing. Like suppose that I want to explore that meaning of any other word like the petitioner. So I can highlight these words and say no more option will appear here, and dictionary you will get there. So you will get the dictionary here. So in this way you will get the English dictionary, and when you select that any Latin word, it will show you the maxims as well. So there is no need to open the dictionary separately. So this is the way you can do. And you will get the hyperlink. When you read any of the judgment, suppose that if you are reading the book, so you will get the reference. But advantage here is that when you're reading this text of the judgment on the Manupatra platform, you will get the hyperlink and you can open that particular judgment. So at the time of reading, it's very simple. You have to click here and you will get the either the any of the judgment or any of the act and section which is referred in this judgment. So you can open as well that act and section things. So now at the time of drafting, you want to take some portion. Like suppose that I have selected this portion and I am preparing one note. So simply you have to do copy. So there is no restrictions, and I'm opening just Word here. I can see here, when I paste this thing, I'll get the footnote of this from where, which case we have taken this judgment. So it will show in the footnote. So whatever the judgment's relevant part you want to take, so you can just copy paste. You in the footnote, you will get that thing. So there is no need to again do the copy paste of the name of that particular judgment. So you can recall from which judgment you have taken. So it will give the ease of drafting or saving any of the note. Various features we have given on the top of this judgment. One is the select language. So this is the Google Translate. We can't rely on that one, but if you want to read in the Bangla, you have to just select the Bengali. It will translate in the Bengali, but we can't rely. This is the Google Translate. Now I'm explaining in the features, this feature is important para. It is for the Supreme Court of India judgment only. So when you click here, so whatever the judgment, this feature you will get there. So it will show you which paragraph is important para, and that paragraph is quoted by some other honorable judge in their judgment. So simply you have to click here, and you will get here that link of these important paras. So the judgment is open here. I just want to see which part is important paragraph. So this is the important para, and this paragraph is cited in this Hardeep Singh State of Punjab. So you can see here. You can see that particular judgment where it has this judgment of 2012 and 2014. It has cited here. So if I am going to cite this particular paragraph, I have a liberty to quote these two other judgments as well after reading of these judgment. So this is the immediate, you will get the link of that thing. So this is another paragraph and where it has cited, so you will get that link. So this is the very important feature you can utilize at the time of drafting, preparing any petition or preparing any reply or preparing any draft. If you are going to quote any of the paragraph, you can check that thing where it has cited any other judgment or not. So this is the important para feature. This cited in para feature you will get in the this databases. It will explain after the 2012 the pronouncement of this judgment where it has cited. So you will get the link of that things. So these will show you recently it is cited in Rajasthan High Court or in the Supreme Court in 2020 it has cited there in this particular paragraph. I can open that particular judgment as well. So instantly it will give the link of these judgment. Then this is the interactive timeline feature. So it will tell you how many times it has cited, where it has relied on listings. So you will get these analytical tools. So it will give you, so where it has relied on, simply you have to click the relied on feature. So it will, you will get the idea what this Rohitas Kumar is relied on this particular judgment. So then this is the case map. Case map is a tool where you will get the top 20 judgment analysis. So this Rohitas Kumar judgment, in this Rohitas Kumar judgment, these 10 cases cited, top 10 cases cited, and these Rohitas Kumar judgment further cited in 10 other 10 cases. So I'll get that circles here. And that is the link with this arrow. So different arrow you are getting there. When you keep the cursor on the arrow, so it will tell you where, in this case, where it is mentioned or distinguished or relied on. If you're getting any red line, then you will get the arrow, is it overruled judgment. So these legend, in this legend, you will get that detail of this feature. So instantly we will get the idea about that particular judgment. That judgment, if I cited anywhere, so what happened in that particular judgment? So you will get the idea. So it will give that clarity. If suppose that if this judgment is distinguished in this particular judgment, so I can read that particular judgment to what the honorable judge is talking about these particular things. So this tool will help you to get that whatever the things which happen after that pronouncement of that particular judgment, you will get the entire detail of that things. This is the important catchword. Whatever the catchword which is mentioned in this particular judgment, you will get that important catchword list, and you can go directly on that these catchword by clicking there. So it will highlight in that portion. Then the you can see after it, whatever the people who have read this judgment, whatever the other judgment they have read. So you will get that things option here as well by clicking this one. You can download the these judgment in the PDF or Word as per your convenient. You can download either the PDF or Word, or simply you can mail. Like suppose that in college campus you are getting the access of Manupatra, and you found some of the judgment which is relevant for you. So what you can do, simply you can open this one, and you can write your mail ID in this, write your mail ID and say send. So this will go as a attachment of this judgment. You will get the PDF copy on your mail ID, or you can send this judgment PDF things to your colleague as well. So this is the very easy way to get the this thing as a PDF on your mailbox. So this cloud feature we have given here as well. So you are using the cloud feature of Dropbox and Google Drive account. So whatever the this judgment, if you want to upload on your cloud, simply you have to click here. It will ask your the Dropbox or Google Drive sign-in credential, and directly you can save on this Google Drive or Dropbox. So on the cloud, you can directly save. Inside the Manupatra, you can save this thing, this judgment, by creating folders. And like I've created these folders, and I want to save these things under this service matter. So I have to just click here and say save. So it will save that things in this place. So in this way, and further you can recall by my save doc. So through this my save doc, you can recall these things. Like suppose that I have to click the service and I'll get this detail here. So I have saved this Rohitas Kumar. I can open this particular things. So this is the I've explained the features. So whatever the things you have given them, you can take advantages of these features. Whatever the searches you have performed here, like suppose that I have to see whatever the decision of this Bangladesh Supreme Court. So simply I have to click here. I can just see the list of here, Supreme Court of Bangladesh Appellate Division. I can click here and I'll get the list of that things. So similarly, I can read here. Some of the features you will not get here in the top in the whatever the things I have shown you. But you can browse these things here with proper hyperlink. So these judgment you can browse here. You can search with this search. Like I have selected the Bangladesh Appellate Division. I want to search under this ad hoc appointment. So like I have written here the word ad hoc. I have marked as a double quote. This, when you provide the any search string within the inverted comma, so it will search both the word at together the between these two words, there will be no other words. So you can type this quote things. So you will get as a phrase. So it is refining under this 139 judgment. You got the 28 judgment. So this is the list of the decisions where the which is related to seniority and promotion and the other topic, whatever the things I have refined on ad hoc. So you can refine in that one. Under that, if I want to read the larger bench decisions, like five or more member bench decisions, so simply I have to click here. So these are the larger bench decisions. So simply I have to click here. You can see here, so this is the decisions. You will get the print replica here as well. So either Supreme Court or Bangladesh site or the any other journals print replica, this is the print replica of BLD. And then you will get here the, like I explain you, this is the larger name. So you're getting the honorable judge's name. So the judge's name you're getting in the top. These decisions you will get there. And as I explain you, these sections are hyperlinked. Simply you have to click here. So this Administrative Tribunals Act, you're getting of Bangladesh, and you can read this sections at the time of reading the judgment. So there is no need to open the Bayer Act. So at the time of doing the research work, simultaneously you can read that this Bayer Act or any of the judgment which is cited by court, that honorable judge, you can read that thing. So this is the way to do Manu search. I just want to explain the this search tips. Like, please read these search tips. Normal query, you can write the like the way I have written there. So there is no need to type entire sentence. Whatever the keywords are there, just type the main keywords. So don't write the entire keywords or say to service law, because you will not get the service law word inside the judgment. Similarly, you can do as I explained the phrase search. Just any of the phrase you can mark in the inside the inverted comma. Then ending oring options are there in auto feature. You will get the ending and oring option. There is no need to write these punctuations. So, and the spell check you will get there. Wildcard. So you can use this asterisk marks. So please read this one. It will help you how to do a better research with a Manu search. And it is AI is inbuilt. So you will get the most relevant judgment on the first page. Similarly, Manu search, you will get the, I'm explaining the legal search. Legal search is a field-based search. Like suppose that if I want to search any of the judgment of, like suppose that if I want to search in the, only in the Dhaka, Bangladesh databases. So I can select here. I can select, when I select here the Bangladesh, it has restricted to search in the Bangladesh databases only. And I have the one party name, like the Ministry of Law and Justice. So I have written here the Ministry of Law and Justice versus such and such. So I can write here the one party name, though there is no need to type versus VSS. So just type that party name and search. It will give the result, whatever the judgment where the one party is the Ministry of Law and Justice. So now you can see here. I got here the Supreme Court Appellate Division 37 judgment and High Court Division 26 judgment. And these things are the keywords, honorable judge's name of this decision. The year wise you are getting, the bench wise, whatever things I have explained here. And here, like suppose that this judgment is important, appellate. You can add this thing to add to session list. So when you, like suppose that this other judgment is important for you. So you can mark it add to session list. So there are the three things are there. So you will get the this green circle and this open document new window. You can open the document new window as well instead of opening the same place. And add to session list is the third one. So you can say the add to session list. Advantage of add to session list, whatever the important judgment of this session, you can add these things in the last of the session. When you click here, you will get the list of that particular judgment. You can take both. If you want to take a printout of both the judgment, you can take a printout, mail, save. You can do this exercise. So this is a very easy to do research work. Similarly, in this place, you can select the subject as well. Like suppose that I have to search the constitution. So constitution related judgment. So simply I have to search and it will give the result of that things. So in this way, you can type that subject, you can refine that one. Similarly, you will search by the date range wise. So you can provide the range of that here. So decision range, you can provide here. So it will search, like suppose that I have to search the judgment of last year. So simply you have to give that year range and it will select 2001. So these range you have to give there and you can search the judgment and 2000 till 2002. I have to just browse this judgment. When I search, so it will give the result of that things. You will get that result. So this is the legal search. You can search by the any of the party name. So whatever the time you want to search the party name wise, so there is no need to search in the Manu search. You have to perform the search in the legal search. So these searches you can perform here. Now I'm just going to show you citation search. In this place, one thing is important. In the legal search, act search is there. Like suppose that I have to read that constitution of Bangladesh. So I have to select here the international law and I have to write here the constitution. So when you write 2-3 letter, so it will give the list of these things, the constitution of Republic of the Republic of People's Republic of Bangladesh. So simply you have to select that things and view selected act. You can open that particular WARE Act in single doc. Or if you want to browse any of the Indian laws, like the Constitution of India. So simply you have to click here the Constitution of India. So similarly, you can browse here that WARE Act. So this WARE Act, you can directly browse that any of the, I've shown you the browsing of the WARE Act through this table of content wise. Similarly, you can do through the act wise as well. So you can browse this any of the WARE Act. So whatever the time I have to browse the any of the Bangladesh WARE Act, I have to select the international law and I have to write here that like the contract. So it will give the list of that thing, then the contract act of this thing. I can open that one. So this is the way to find the search the WARE Act. Now I'm coming the important part, another important part, the citations. So sometimes in the textbook, you're getting the citations. Like so many Indian citations, which is regularly cited by Honorable Supreme Court of Bangladesh. Or sometimes you are getting the search, like suppose that I'm just searching the one citation here. I'm the citation of, say, AIR. So Indian citation, 1917-3. So you have to fill this form and paste. 1461, I've written here, search. So I got this judgment. So this is the judgment of Israelis case 1 and Bharti judgment you will get there. The full text of judgment you are getting there. Similarly, if suppose that if you have any citation of Bangladesh things, so you have to select the international citation and you have to select, like suppose that I have the citation of ADC of this citation of 2017 and volume number is 14A and the page number is 1. So you have to fill this detail and say search. So you can search this judgment. So in this way, you will get the judgment. You're getting the print replica of the Supreme Court of Bangladesh here. So this is the way. And so these entire judgment you're getting there. So here, I'm just going to show you, like suppose that here you are getting the one decision of Canada, which is Kotayo Honorable. So you can open that particular judgment. So you can see the Supreme Court of Canada judgment. You can see here. So what about the judgment? So this is the advantage. You're searching your case law, Honorable Judge has cited some case law of international databases. You're getting the link of that things. So there is no need to search these things in your library, going to in the library and find out these things. So this is the citation search. Now I'm coming here the another search parameter we have mentioned is the assisted search. In this assisted search, sometimes In Manu search, as I explained, you have to provide, if you are searching two words together, so you provide within the inverted comma, or two, three words within 10 words, inverted comma, slash 10. So these, all the parameters are written here. Simply you have to feed the detail according to, like, all these word, any of these word, exact this phrase, number, none of these word, these words. So just whatever, like, suppose I'm just taking the example, like I'm searching in the Bangladesh databases. I'm taking the one example, like suppose that lease agreement. One phrase is lease agreement. And I want to search two words here, eviction. So I'm searching one case law, which is related to the rent thing. And there is one lease agreement. And this is the case of eviction of tenant. So I just want to find out these eviction tenant, the inside judgment, these two words should be within 10 words. So I have marked it, the eviction of the tenant, eviction tenant, tenant was that things. So I have selected this eviction tenant, lease agreement. I can also, so whatever the parameter I can search here, I have searched here. So it will show you the result. So I got this 15 result. So like suppose that I don't want any word like the commercial. So I can search. So these things also I can refine. If I'm getting one word in the judgment, so two judgment, now you can see the only 13 judgment is there out of 15. Two, if I possible, two judgment which is related to commercial lease. So in this way, you can frame your query in this place. So there, just read these things, whatever the things, like suppose that you have to search exact phrase, you have to right here, you have to search the number of none of these word within a sentence, within the proximity of number of words. So you can write here all these words. So whatever the detail you will feed, either you have to fill detail of one field or multiple field, you can feed here and you can search. So you can, you will get that result. So this is the way this assisted search. This is just like a part of Manu search, but these field option we have given here. So it's ease of doing this research. You can do a research. At the time of reading the judgment, sometimes you prepare note and you want to add the note with the judgment. So this notepad feature we have given there. So at the time of reading the judgment, I can add my note. So I have to click here the notepad feature. So that add to my notepad. So first of all, I have to click here. I have to give the one title here. Like suppose that I have written here the one word demo. The title I've given there. I want to write here something. So you can write simultaneously. And if you want to add some portion of this judgment in this note, you can just do a copy paste. And the last you have to do, submit. You can save that thing. So vis-a-vis, you can do these things, these activity. And advantage of this thing, so you will get here the your note. So whenever you open this judgment, you will get your note. Or you can share these things on the real time. Like suppose that I have to send this note to my colleague. So I can send this note to my colleague here. Yeah? So simply I have to send the mail. So you can prepare, you have given them some remarks to prepare that note. So you can prepare, that fellow will prepare the note according to your remarks. So instantly you can send that note to, you can take a printout as well. You can send the mail as well. So this is the My Notepad feature. So these are the search tools I've explained you. Whatever the topic when you search, like suppose that if I'm searching gender justice. So we have given here the article search feature. So whatever the article we have in the, our databases, apart from that, I want to search the these article of which is available on other platform. So you can search these things by clicking here. So it will show you these article, legal articles, which is available in other databases. Like this is available in Taylor Francis site. So these things you will get there. So you can search the article which is not available in Manupatra platform, but it is available in other platform. Directly you can search by clicking here. The beginning, I told you to, I will explain the legal taxonomy. Legal taxonomy is in fact the, whatever the Indian databases are there. So even the subject wise search, so there is a subject index we have given there. So in the, like the civil procedure, I want to search an appeal. So further you will get the sub subject and the, whatever the case law related to that query, you will get there. So these things you will get there. So these options are there. So I'm just showing you the, on this Manupatra page, you will get here the training session, like training things. So here you will get the training manual, how to use videos. So in training manual, whatever the things I will explain you, so you will get all the details here. Like suppose that I have to do search. So you will get whatever the things I will explain you. So these things are written here. So you will get all the features detailed in this training manual. So you can take the help of this training manual. Similarly, we have given the various videos of various features. So you can browse these videos as well. And we are running a webinar series. So many sessions we have done. So you will get that link on our YouTube things. Just you have to subscribe Manupatra on YouTube. You will get that link of these recording of webinar. So you can listen that things. And we'll send you these video to your that email ID. And if you have any query related to these, any topic related query, so simply you have to write on that is contact at manupatra.com or contact at bdlex.com. You can write here. Anytime you can call on our Dhaka number. So I'm just showing you bdlex.com site. On this site, you can contact on these numbers as well. These numbers are available. So anytime for any query, any difficulty, so you can directly call on these mobile number. So we'll assist you anytime. So now you can ask your query. I'm just taking your. So as you ask about the recording of these things, I have already explained you. We will send you the recording of this session. Any other question, if you have, please ask. Just a minute. You can ask your query. So please ask your query, Mr. Islam. Please ask your query. So I hope this training session is useful for you, and you can, if you have any difficulty, any of the problem, you can mark to us, you can call us, our colleague, on the given mobile number. So we will assist you anytime. Hope all of you are at home, stay safe, and wish you again a very, very happy Ramadan. Enjoy your festive season. Thanks a lot for sharing your time and seeing that our presentation. थैंक यू। So another question I am getting here. How can I find case summary? So as I explained, the case summary you will get there when you open any of the judgment, that case note you will get there. Before the judgment, you will get the case note. So case note is in fact the case summary. So please browse the BARE Act. Any of the judgment, you will get the case summary of that particular case. That case note is in fact the case summary of that things. You will get the subject, on which subject this judgment is there, and the whatever the case note, you will get there. As you have written, that difficult to see some part and your screen is unclear, so you will get that video link. So on your email ID, we'll send you the video link. So please see that video. Any other question, please ask. Thank you. Thanks a lot.